Hello everyone and welcome back to Dark Souls. We were going to go to the catacombs, but I forgot we had a firekeeper's soul, so let's bring that in first so that we can heal for just a little bit more. And now let's go to the catacombs. We're only going there, as I might have said before, to kill Pinwheel so we can further kindle our bonfires, and then we're going just back, and then we're going to Darkwood Garden to kill the Moonlight Butterfly and to kill Sif and all that. So first we're going to go up the elevator and fall down so we can grab some chests with loot before we go down to the catacombs. The way we're gonna do it is like this. Okay, did not hurt that much. No. Some homeward bones always come in handy. Okay, now it's time to get into the catacombs. Now I'm only going to do Pinwheel, but when we get there again, I might explore it entirely, but all I know is that the catacombs are annoying. So I might just, when we want to go to the Tomb of Giants, I might just skip the entire catacombs, just go to the Tomb of Giants to kill Gravelord Nido, because even the Tomb of Giants is a pain in the ass. Okay, big ones give a lot of souls, that's good. Okay, big one down, that will make it out a lot easier. Scimitar. Cool weapon, but not of use to us. Okay, binoculars. Those are not of use to us either. Now to find the way down. Ah, over there. Huh. Can't remember what area that is. That might be Lower Undeadburg, I think. Okay, this part can be annoying too, but as long as we run past it very fast, it should not be too much of a problem. If I can remember where to go. Crap. Yeah, I'll just climb down then. Ugh. Oh, crap. Now we go in here. No. Kill the necromancer. So the skeletons die permanently. Okay. Am I human? No. I'm going to kindle this bonfire, you never know. If I should die here somewhere. I hope I don't, that I can do this in one shot, but you can never be too sure. Voila. Now push this lever all the way in there so we can proceed. I'm just going to go take this easy and oh crap. Kill all enemies just so I can get some souls. Always handy to have some more souls. Is it already here that the statues can hurt you? No. Here they don't hurt you yet, but further in the catacombs, the statues will shoot out spikes, and they can really annoy or hurt you. Whoa, okay. Don't need to kill these skeletons yet, because the necromancer is still alive. Are you kidding me? Because that skeleton also fell down. I bumped into it. And he threw me off the cliff. Bastard. Okay, well, that's what happens when you expect things to go flawlessly. Okay, now just run. Ow, ow, ow. No, not again, not again. Yeah, and then I just fall off. God. Oh, God, I suck so hard. Okay, I think I'm going to just kill the necromancer. I'm just gonna take this nice and slow. Because else we'll have too many deaths on our hands, and it's really not good for the playthrough. The necromancer is not going to make this easy on me. Okay, I'm going to run towards the necromancer. Okay, that takes care of him. Now we can kill all the skelly. Or just do the jump. Here we are. Okay, now not to get our ass handed by any of the pinwheels. Did it just keep rolling? Perfect. Okay, I'm just gonna run for it. These pinwheels suck. No, 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 no. I'm gonna make it. I'm gonna make it. I'm gonna make it. Ooh, that was close. Okay, now this boss should not be any problem because this, you know, this should be the easiest boss in the entire game. He definitely looks scary, but he's not any problem. He just has not a lot of hit points. The masks are cool. I'll give that to him. The music is kind of fancy too. And that was Pinwheel. Easy as pie. And now we can kindle until 20 Estus flasks. Mosque of the Father, did that do something for us? 9856. Raises equipment load. Oh, cool, okay. Always handy. Let's use a homeward bone. So we can get back to the Firelink Shrine. And then we'll go to Darkroot Forest. Yeah, let's just kill these guys before they become any annoyance. Oh well, they give little soul, but it's better than nothing. Okay, now I gotta heal because else I'm not gonna survive this. Okay. No, I should be safe. Well, I have to get back to Firelink, hopefully not die and lose all of my 21k souls. Okay, now we're safe. I'll ambush him here. Oh yeah, now Frampt is here. But to get the other guy, I don't think we can already speak to him, so I'm not going to speak to him. Just gonna rest at the bonfire. And then we're going to go to Andre and first level up our Black Knight Halberd a little bit. How much equip load do I have? 70.6, and without the mask, damn, it increases it by 3 and a bit. That's pretty nice. I hope once we get Havel's armor, we can wear it. That we have enough equip load, that would be awesome. It would make Ornstein and Smaug so much easier. There's the blacksmith. Okay, do I have? I have a lot of twin humanity, so I'm gonna use some to kindle that bonfire. Because after Dark Roots, we're going through Sense Fortress. But that's for after we've killed, or after we've cleared Dark Roots, Garden, and Basin. Because there's quite some stuff that we can do there. Ah, 20 Estus flasks. That's gonna give us a lot of leeway to survive a lot of crap. Okay, I'll give you the ember. Reinforced weapon. It costs a lot, if I remember correctly. Okay, costs 2,000. There, it's already at 3. We'll have a bonfire soon, so we'll just not level up yet. I hope if we can farm 5,000 souls more, we can buy the Mark of Artorias, and we can go somewhere else. Those Titanite demons, they really are an annoyance. But, well, they're not too hard. Okay, we just need 3, 2 point whatever K souls. And then we can buy the Crest of Artorias. We'll just go do the Moonlight Butterfly first. Shouldn't be any problem. Ow. Remember last time we were here, just for a bit? That I needed 3 swings to kill the little tree guys? Now you'll just die in one. Well, I could have gone through this area before I got into Blighttown so that we would have had some purple moss clumps. But whatever. We made it through Blighttown relatively unscathed. Nope, you're not gonna grab me. Gonna take some more humanity so that we can kindle the next bonfire here. Which is right over here. Now we have 20 Estus flasks here as well, and now we'll be able to easily kill the Moonlight Butterfly. This is where we enter the Crest of Artorias, and we have a little shortcut then, towards the next boss, Sif. One of the coolest bosses in the entire game. Also one of the saddest boss fights in the entire game. Oh, I can... You're not gonna ambush me. Thought there were 3 of them. Yep. I was correct. What are the scaling of the Black Knight Helmet? D and E. It's really crap scaling. But it's very powerful, so. And now we'll see how powerful it really is against those. Ow. Okay. Normally with the Drake Sword it takes a lot of hits to kill those guys. Okay, I'm going to pull them one by one. Alright, that's one down. Now, kill. Okay. It's easy if you just want to buff yourself, then I can kill you faster. Elite Knight, I am going to wear that at one point, just before we get to Anorlon though, probably. But not yet. Here is another Guardian. We're first going to explore this area before we go up here, because up here is where we fight the Moonlight Butterfly. Also one of the easiest bosses in the game. If you can dodge it, then it's easy. Yes, keep buffing yourself. There should be something around here, guarded by snakes. There are some more forest people. Oh, they missed me. Nice. And then we should be able to... Here, it might look like a normal tree, but if you look at it very closely, you can see it's moving. So, what do? we kill the moving tree. And ta-da! The secret passage appears. And then we have some stingrays or whatever the hell they are, or mantas. Where do we go from here? Oh, down here. And there's another living tree that we can just kill. And then we can go explore this area a little bit. It's not too big of an area, if I remember. We can go down here to get some ring, but first we're going here. Oh, and some stingrays. Awesome. Oh, snap. Stingray almost hit me. Some more here. Nope. Okay, that's it here. Now we go back and we go up. What ring do I actually have equipped? Oh, okay, that's the ring that I do not need anymore. Well, not for the time being. We'll need it when we face off against the Hydra. Because it's in the water, and then we want to move as fast as we can. But if we have a 100 damage reduction shield, the Hydra should also be no problem at all. And now we come up here. I forgot an item there. Okay, great. The wolf ring, it increases our poise. So then we can get hit and still hit people. I think we can use that ring for a good while. In the end, we will need Havel's ring to just walk around in the Havel set. But for now, we can use this one. We will not have the Havel Ring for some time. Well, we will have the Havel Ring for in the next episode, I think, but we won't have the Havel set in a while. Because that's only when we get to Anor Londo, that's where you get the Havel armor set. Now we can go fight the butterfly. We will need our shield to block some of its attacks. Where are you? Ah, there she is. Or he or whatever. It. There it is. Those attacks can be blocked. They have to be dodged. And those are the only attacks she ever does. And now we just wait until she comes to the edge of the bridge to rest for a while, and then we can kill her. I just... Oh, we have enough Estus, so... whoop. Oh, cool, we dodged that attack. Does not happen often. Come on, go rest. Ow, ow. Yes, now she comes to rest. And we do a lot of damage against her. It's just ridiculous. Well... And that was the Moonlight Butterfly for you. Told you, also one of the easiest bosses in the game. Now that we have some more souls, we can, well, we can go by the crest of Artorias, and then we'll continue. But first, Watchtower Basement Key, that we can enter Havel the Rock's room and get the Havel Ring from him. And Homer Bone and Divine Ember. And now we can go back. And not forget to pick up that item that's there. Souls are always valuable. There's someone behind me. Nope. Oh crap. Oh, some more purple moss clump. Well, we can choose. We can kill Andre. Not recommended. Or we can buy the crest from Andre. If you kill Andre, you get the crest. But you don't have to pay the souls, but you lose Andre. So I'm not gonna kill him, I'm just gonna buy it. We have enough souls, so... Okay, I'll give you that ember too. Purchase item. Crest of Arcturus. We'll buy that and that. And then we'll just learn a gesture with you. Thank you, bye bye. And now we can go back. Since I haven't rested at a bonfire, the enemies should not have respawned. I hope. First, we're going to just consume some more souls. First go to the bonfire, and then we'll use the souls to level up some more. Souls, wow, it's not worth it. Whatever. Do I have more souls? Nope. Okay, now we're just gonna re-equip Swinging Manatees, all the bones. And probably level up. Oh, once. Wow. Great. Ah, well. Alright, guys. Next time, we're going to insert the Crest of Artorias and go to Darkroot Basin. I'll see you guys next time.